Dear students, welcome back to my YouTube channel John Lewis 3D Learning. In this presentation, we are going to see 10th standard chemistry calculation based on chemical equation from mole concept chapter. So let's work out some problems here. So problem number one, calculate the weight of potassium nitrite. See, potassium nitrite formed by thermal decomposition of 15.15 gram of potassium nitrate. So when potassium nitrate is decomposed, potassium nitrite is formed, then we need to find out the weight. Okay, potassium atomic weight is 39, nitrogen is 14 and oxygen is 16. So first of all, we need to write the equation for this. The chemical equation for the reaction is 2KNO3 gives, that is an action of heat, that gives 2KNO2 plus O2. See, in some of the problems this equation will be given, and if it is not given, we should be able to complete the equation and balance it. Mostly they will give you the equation. If not given, we should be able to write the equation. So here you need to learn, when potassium nitrate is heated, what is formed? Potassium nitrite plus oxygen is formed. We know how to balance it already, therefore I have given the balanced equation here. Now how to find, what is the question here? So 15.15 gram of potassium nitrate is heated. So 15.15 grams of potassium nitrate, how much potassium nitrite is formed? That is, what is the question? Okay, first of all, what we need to do, we need to find out the molecular weight of potassium nitrate and also the molecular weight of potassium nitrite. So the molecular weight of potassium nitrate, KNO3, is equal to, potassium is 39, nitrogen is 14 and oxygen is 16. 16 into 3 is 48. Therefore, if we sum up this, we will get 101. This is what is the molecular weight of potassium nitrate. Then what we need to find out, potassium nitrite also, because we need to find out how much potassium nitrite is formed. Therefore, the molecular weight of potassium nitrite is equal to 39 plus 14, 39, nitrogen is 14, oxygen is 16 into 2. Therefore, if you sum up all these things, you will get 85. Now, from this, what we understand from this balanced equation, the molecular weight of potassium nitrate is 101. Therefore, 2 into 101 grams of potassium nitrate gives how many grams of potassium nitrate? 2 into, what is its molecular weight? 85. 2 into 85 grams of potassium nitrite. So in problem, what they are asking, if you take 15.15 gram of potassium nitrate, how much is formed? Therefore, we can easily work out here. So 2 into, what is the molecular weight of this compound? 2 into 101 grams of potassium nitrate yield how much? Here 2 into, what is the molecular weight of this? 2 into 85 grams of potassium nitrite. Here it should be KNO2. It should be KNO2, okay. Okay, now, so 2 into 128 grams of potassium nitrate yield 2 into 85 grams of potassium nitrate. But what they are asking, 15.15 gram of potassium nitrate. Therefore, 15.15 gram of potassium nitrate yield is equal to how much? So you have to multiply this into this divided by this. Therefore, 15.15 into 2 into 85 divided by how much this is? 2 into 101. So if you do the simplification, you will get 12.75 grams of potassium nitrate. Therefore, what is the answer? When 15.15 gram of potassium nitrate is heated, we will get 12.75 grams of potassium nitrate. So same problem. What we need to do is, we have to write the chemical equation in the very first place. So here, whatever be the weight on the reactant side, divided by its molecular weight into number of moles, that's what we need to take. So the molecular weight of potassium nitrate is 101. Molecular weight of potassium nitrate is 85. Already we have calculated in the previous page. Okay, now, so the weight taken, what is the weight taken of the reactant? 15.15 divided by number of moles. See, whatever the balanced equation, no, the, what is the number we are getting here? The number of moles into molecular weight of the reactant. that is equal to, so how much weight is formed, that is what we need to find out, how much weight is formed, we can keep it as x divided by number of moles into molecular weight of the product. So n into molecular weight of the product, number of moles, that is what is in the balanced equation, you will get some number, no, that number, if there is no number, that is equal to 1. Here it is 2, therefore we have to put 2 here into molecular weight. Just to substitute, remember this formula, weight of the reactant taken divided by number of moles into molecular weight of the reactant is equal to weight of the product formed divided by number of moles into molecular weight of the product formed. Just remembering this formula, we can easily work out. So what is the weight taken? 15.15. What is the number of moles of the reactant? 2. And what is its molecular weight? 101. Therefore, 2 into 101 is equal to, what is the weight form? That is what we need to calculate, therefore keep it as x, divided by n into molecular weight of the product, 2 into potassium nitrite. Therefore, 2 into the molecular weight of potassium nitrite is 85. So from this we can calculate x easily. Keep x on the left hand side, all the other things to the right hand side. Therefore, x is equal to, what do you get? 15.15 into 2 into 85, divided by 2 into 101. If you do the simplification, what do you get? You get 12.75 grams of KNO2. Just by remembering this formula, this is very easy to remember. But we need to remember the n number of moles, reactant and product. That is why we need to balance the equation perfectly. Hope you understood this. Once you understand this one, it's easy to work out the remaining problems. I have explained you 3 more problems, and then I have given you 2 problems for you to work out on your own. So what is the second problem? Copper on reacting with concentrated sulfuric acid. Therefore, we need to write copper reaction with concentrated sulfuric acid, what it gives. Copper sulfate plus sulfur dioxide plus water. And that equation we need to balance in the very first place. So produces copper sulfate. If 1.28 grams of copper is to be converted to copper sulfate, find, first question, the weight of copper sulfate form, second one, the weight of the acid required. First of all, what we need to do, we need to write the equation and balance it. The chemical equation for the reaction is copper plus concentrated sulfuric acid. I give you a simple rule to remember these products here. When any metal reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid, you will get that metal sulfate. Since it is copper here, you are getting copper sulfate plus water plus sulfur dioxide. This is a standard rule. Metal plus concentrated sulfuric acid gives metal sulfate plus water plus sulfur dioxide. Since it is copper, since the metal is copper here, we are getting copper sulfate. And water and sulfur dioxide products are standard. Always you will get water and sulfur dioxide. Is it clear? We need to balance the equation. Already we have learnt very thoroughly how to balance the equation. So I have been emphasizing this point very often in every video, that you should know how to write the molecular formula correctly in the very first place. And then we need to balance the equation perfectly, without which nothing can be done, not only in this chapter, even in all the remaining 10 chapters also, we cannot learn properly. Therefore, you master the chemical formulas on how to write the equation and how to balance them correctly. Okay, now, so what is the question here? What is the first question? The weight of copper sulfate formed. How much copper sulfate is formed when 1.28 grams are taken? Here, what is the weight of copper? The weight of copper is 64 grams. The molecular weight of sulfuric acid is, you have to take the formula H2SO4, and using these atomic weights, already you know how to calculate the molecular weights. So we can easily find out the molecular weight of sulfuric acid using the formula, that is 98. What is the weight of copper sulfate? That we will do it in the next page, because we'll take the first sum first and then we will do the second sum. Okay, so from this what we understand, if you take, so only one copper here in the balanced equation, therefore 1 into 64 is 64, therefore 64 grams of copper react with how many grams of sulfuric acid? What is the molecular weight of sulfuric acid? 98 grams. But here how many moles of sulfuric acid in the balanced equation? 2 moles. Therefore, 2 into 98 grams of sulfuric acid. But what is the problem given? If you take 1.28 grams of copper, therefore, if you take 1.28 grams of copper, that will react with how many grams of sulfuric acid? That will be equal to 1.28 into 2 into 98 divided by 64. So if you divide 64, 1.28, you will get 0.02. Okay, so if you do the calculation, you will get 3.92 grams of sulfuric acid. That is what is the answer for the first question. How much of sulfuric acid is required? What is the second question? The weight of copper sulfate formed. Or if you want to do this calculation, how we can do it? So weight of copper taken divided by the atomic weight of copper is 64. But there is no number here, therefore only 1. Therefore we have taken 1 into 64. That is equal to how much sulfuric acid it reacts with. Therefore X divided by what is the weight of sulfuric acid here? Molecular weight is 98. How many moles of sulfuric acid it reacts? 2 moles. Therefore 2 into 98. Therefore X is equal to 1.28 into 2 into 98 divided by 64. So if you do this calculation, you will get 3.92 grams of sulfuric acid. So this is a shortcut, no? Very, very simple. We need not work out always all these various steps. Okay, shall we move on to the second question in this? Okay, what is this? This is the same chemical equation. What is the weight of copper? 64. And what is the weight of copper sulfate formed? Copper sulfate formula we know, and using the atomic weights, if you find out its molecular weight, that is equal to 160 gram. So copper is also 1, copper sulfate is also 1. Therefore 64 grams of copper produces how much copper sulfate? 160 grams. 64 gram of copper yield 160 gram of copper sulfate. But how much we are taking? We have taken only 1.28 grams of copper. Therefore 1.28 grams of copper will yield how much? 1.28 into 160 divided by 64. So that will be equal to 3.2 grams of copper sulfate. If you want to do it in shortcut method, what we can do? So we need to take weight of copper divided by what is the atomic weight of copper? 64 is equal to how much copper sulfate is formed? We need to find out. What is the molecular weight of copper sulfate that we have calculated to 160? Here it is only 1 copper sulfate. Therefore that is 160. Therefore X is equal to, bring 160 this side, 1.28 into 160 divided by 64. If you do this calculation, you will get 3.2 grams of copper sulfate. Is it clear? See, I have given you the regular method how we can work out, and also I have given you a shortcut method to do that. Okay, now let us work out few more problems so that we can get the fundamentals very clearly. Okay, problem number 3. From the equation, see here, they have given the equation. Good teacher, they have given the equation. Okay, calcium carbonate plus 2 hydrochloric acid gives calcium chloride plus water plus carbon dioxide. Even that is balanced. So they have given the balanced equation. Calculate the weight of calcium chloride obtained from 10 grams of calcium carbonate and the volume at STP of carbon dioxide. So instead of asking weight, they are asking the volume of carbon dioxide, because carbon dioxide is a gas. It can be measured in volume also. How we can do that? Same way. First you write the equation, balance it. Now first you find out the molecular weight of calcium carbonate. So using this formula, CaCO3, and all the atomic weights given, if you calculate, that is equal to 100 grams. And what is the first question? How much of calcium chloride is formed? Therefore you take molecular weight of calcium chloride. The molecular weight of calcium chloride, we know the formula, CaCl2. Substitute its atomic weights here and you find out the molecular weight. That will be equal to 111 grams. From this, what we understand? So this is 1 CaCO3 and 1 CaCl2. Therefore 100 grams of calcium carbonate produced 111 grams of calcium chloride. But here how much calcium carbonate is taken? Calculate the weight of calcium chloride obtained from 10 grams of calcium carbonate. Therefore if you take 10 grams of calcium carbonate, that will produce how much of calcium chloride? Therefore 10 into 111 divided by 100. Okay, if you simplify this 10, therefore if you simplify, denominator will become 10. If you divide 111 by 10, you will get 11.1 gram of calcium chloride. How we can do it in shortcut? What is calcium carbonate? Here it's only 1. So what is the weight of calcium carbonate in the sum given? 10 grams. Therefore 10 divided by, what is the molecular weight we found? 100. That is equal to how much calcium chloride is formed? X divided by what is the molecular weight of calcium chloride? 111. This is only 1. Therefore, 1 into 111 is 111. Therefore, x is equal to 10 into 111 by 100. If you simplify, you will get the same answer, 11.1 gram. Okay, this is a shortcut method. Without writing all the steps, we can immediately find out the answer. Suppose they give you A, B, C, D, which one is the correct one, we can use this method. But they ask you to work out the sum, we have to work out this way. Choose the correct answer, we can use the shortcut. For elaborately finding out the answer, we have to write all the steps. Okay, what is the second question? How much volume of carbon dioxide is obtained at STP? Okay, how then? So now let's proceed with the second calculation here. How much volume of carbon dioxide is produced? Same thing, what we need to take the same equation, balanced equation. Here carbon dioxide 1 mole. So we know 1 mole of any gas occupies 22.4 liters. We need not take molecular weight here because they are asking volume. So this will occupy 22.4 liters. But here only 1 CO2, therefore 1 into 22.4 liters. Suppose it is 2 CO2, we need to take 2 into 22.4 liters. 1 mole of any gas occupies 22.4 liters. Therefore, carbon dioxide volume is 22.4 liters here into 1. Okay, now, first we find out the molecular weight of calcium carbonate. Already we have found out that is 100 gram. So, the molecular weight of carbon dioxide is equal to 44 grams. But what we know, 100 grams of calcium carbonate produced is equal to 44 grams of carbon dioxide. That is equal to 1 mole. 1 mole occupies how much volume? 22.4 liters of carbon dioxide. Since they have not asked weight here, they are asking volume. Therefore, the molecular weight in grams will occupy 22.4 liters of the gas. Therefore, here 10 grams of calcium carbonate. How much calcium carbonate we are taking? 10 grams of calcium carbonate will produce 10 into 22.4 divided by 100. 10 into 22.4 by 100 is equal to, so you cancel 1 0 and 22.4 divided by 10 is equal to 2.24 liters of carbon dioxide. This also can be done by the shortcut method. So weight of the calcium carbonate divided by molecular weight of the calcium carbonate. Here only 1 CaCO3. That is why 1 into 100 is 100. If any other number is there, we have to multiply by that. That is equal to x volume of carbon dioxide. That is what we need to find out. Here, 1 mole of carbon dioxide. That will occupy how much volume? 22.4 liter. Therefore, 22.4. Therefore, x is equal to 10 into 22.4 divided by 100. Again, you will get the same value, 2.24 liters of carbon dioxide. Is it clear? Very, very simple and very easy once you exactly know how to proceed. Very easily we can score 5 marks here. Combustion of butane, butane is C4H10, takes place as follows. They are given the equation and balanced equation also they are given. Butane plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide plus water. So once the equation given, you need not worry. Simply we can take this sum and work out. And they are given the balanced number also. So easy to find out. Okay, what is the first question? Calculate the number of moles of oxygen needed for complete combustion of 58 grams of butane. Here they are not even asking weight, they are not even asking volume. How many moles? In the balanced equation, what we understand? 2 moles of butane. That is 2 moles means what? We have to find out the molecular weight of butane multiplied by 2. So 2 into molecular weight of butane gives 13 moles of oxygen. Therefore 8 moles of oxygen are here 58 grams. Therefore 58 grams of butane will react with how many moles of oxygen? That we can easily find out. See, let us see here. The chemical equation is this. Okay, what we understand here, 2 into molecular weight of butane requires how much? 13 moles of oxygen. They are asking the moles here. They are not even asking weight or the volume. They are asking only the moles. But here, what is the question given? 58 grams of butane only taken. First, let us find out the molecular weight of butane. The molecular weight of butane, that is C4H10, is substitute the atomic weights of carbon and hydrogen. You find out that will be 58. Okay, so from this what we understand, 2 into 58 grams of butane burn with how many moles of oxygen? 13 moles of oxygen. Therefore, the number of moles of oxygen is equal to 13 moles. From this what we understand, 2 into 58 grams of methane needs for combustion is equal to 13 moles of oxygen. But here how much weight is taken, how much weight is given in the sum? Only 58 grams, am I right? Therefore, 58 grams of methane needs for combustion is equal to 58 into 13 divided by 2 into 58. So, 58 into 13 divided by 2 into 58. 58 get cancelled. Therefore, 13 by 2 is equal to 6.5 moles of oxygen. Or simply by shortcut method, what we can take? So, weight divided by molecular weight. Molecular weight is 58. Here, 2 molecules of butane, that is why we are multiplying it by 2 into 58, is equal to, we need to find out the number of moles x. But in the given balanced equation, how many moles of oxygen is there? 13 moles, therefore divided by 13. Therefore, x is equal to, bring the 13 this side, x is equal to 58 into 13 divided by 2 into 58. 58 and 58 get cancelled, 13 by 2 is equal to 6.5 moles of oxygen. Very easy, no? Very, very simple. Okay, what is the second question? The volume of carbon dioxide formed at STP at the same time. Now, volume of carbon dioxide. Therefore, what we need to take? 1 mole of carbon dioxide occupies 2.24 liters. Therefore, here 8 CO2 means what? 8 into 2.24 liters the carbon dioxide occupies. But when you take 58 grams, how much we need to find out? That is what is the question. Okay. Again, problem number B of this problem 4 is what? The volume of carbon dioxide formed at STP, how much? Okay, again take the same equation, it is already balanced. Therefore, what we need to find out? Find out the molecular weight of butane C4H10. Already we have calculated in the previous slide, that was found to be 58 grams. And here they are asking volume of carbon dioxide. Here how much of carbon dioxide is produced? 8 moles of carbon dioxide. What I told you, 1 mole will occupy always 22.4 liters. Therefore here 8 into 22.4 liters. Therefore 2 into 58 grams of butane. 2 into 58 grams of butane produces how much volume? 8 into 22.4 liters of carbon dioxide. 8 into 1 mole of carbon dioxide occupies 22.4 liters of carbon dioxide. Since 8 moles, we are multiplying it by 8. But here how much weight is taken? Just 58 grams. Therefore, 58 grams of butane produces 58 into 8 into 22.4 divided by 2 into 58 divided by 2 into 58. So, 58 and 58 get cancelled. And if you divide this one 4 times, therefore, if you multiply 4 into 22.4, you will get 89.6 liters of carbon dioxide. So, if they are asking us to work out, we have to work out all these steps. Suppose they give A, B, C, D and choose the correct answer, we can use a shortcut method. What is it? Weight of butane divided by number of moles into molecular weight. Number of moles is 2, molecular weight is 58. That is equal to, here, how much volume of carbon dioxide is produced when we take 58 grams divided by, here how many moles of carbon dioxide formed? 8 moles. Each mole occupies how much? 2.24. Therefore, it is 8 into 22.4. 8 into 22.4 liters. I think I mentioned here 2.24. It is 22.4 liters. Okay, bring this value here. X is equal to 58 into 8 into 22.4 divided by 2 into 58. If you do this calculation, you will get 89.6 liters of carbon dioxide. Okay, so never hesitate to rewind the video and watch it again. So watch it second time, you will understand much better. And if you watch it third time, you will understand it thoroughly. And then you can work out on your own later on. So now let's quickly work out some problems ourselves. Try yourself. I give you some idea based on that you need to work out on your own. Okay, let us do this sum. I give you some idea based on that you can work out very quickly. Okay. Here, what is the sum which was asked in 2006 ICSE board examination? What is the volume of ammonia required to completely reduce 120 gram of copper 2 oxide? The equation for the reaction is, okay, it is given, whatever it is given. So we need not bother because it is already balanced. No, simply we should know how many moles and how to find out its molecular weight. and atomic weights are also given. If necessary, we can find out the molecular weight. Here, ammonia is a gas. Therefore, they are asking the volume of ammonia required. Therefore, we need not find out its molecular weight. Since copper 2 oxide weight is given, we need to find out the molecular weight of copper oxide. But what is the shortcut formula we know? Weight of copper oxide, that is 120 gram, divided by number of moles, here it is 3, and molecular weight of cupric oxide. Copper is 64, oxygen is 16. 64 plus 16 is 80. Therefore, 3 into 80 grams of cupric oxide. Therefore, 120 divided by 3 into 80 is equal to, how much volume of ammonia is required? Let it be X divided by, so one volume occupy how much? 22.4 liters. Therefore, 2 into 22.4 is equal to how much, we can easily find out. So, bring this one this side. Therefore, X is equal to 120 into 2 into 22.4 divided by 3 into 80. 120 into 2 is 240. 3 into 80 is also 240. Cancel it. So, what is left? 22.4. So, what is the answer given? 22.4 liters. But in our board examination, they will ask you to write the steps. Just now we have learnt in 4 various sums how to write the steps. And you can write accordingly and you can work out the sum. This is a shortcut method to find out. Okay. So this is the last sum for you to practice. So which was asked in ICSE board examination 2012. So P plus HNO3 gives H3PO4 plus H2O plus 5NO2. They are given very clearly a balanced equation. Here, if 9.3 grams of phosphorus was used, so phosphorus only 9.3 grams was used for the experiment. But what is the atomic weight of phosphorus? 31. It is given here. Therefore, here what we need to take? 9.3 divided by 31. Only one phosphorus. Therefore, 1 into 31. Suppose any balanced number is there, it should be multiplied by that number. That is equal to, what is the first question asked? Number of moles of phosphorus taken. Number of moles is nothing but what? Weight by its atomic weight. If it is an element, weight by atomic weight. If it is a compound, weight by molecular weight. Since phosphorus is an element, weight is 9.3 and atomic weight is 31. If you divide it, you will get 0.3. That is the answer. What is the second question? The mass of phosphoric acid formed. So, phosphoric acid is in the product side. They are asking mass. Therefore, we need to find out the molecular weight of phosphoric acid. But what is given on the left hand side? Phosphorus weight is given 9.3. What is its atomic weight? 31. Because only one phosphorus, 1 into 31 is 31. That is equal to how much phosphoric acid is formed? X divided by here number of moles into molecular weight of phosphoric acid. Number of moles is 1. And molecular weight of phosphoric acid, if you do the calculation using this formula, you will get 98. Therefore, X will be equal to, bring 98 this side, 9.3 into 98 divided by 31. If you simplify 9.3 and 31, you will get 0.3. 0.3 into 98 is equal to, you will get the answer, how much? 29.4 grams. You will get 29.4 grams. Okay, what is the last sum, third sum? The volume of nitrogen dioxide produced at STP. The volume of nitrogen dioxide produced at STP. So, nitrogen dioxide is a gas, isn't it? Nitrogen dioxide is a gas. Therefore, here we need not find out its molecular weight because they are asking volume. NO2, one volume, one mole will occupy 22.4 liters. Here, 5 moles are there. Therefore, 5 into 22.4. So, here weight of phosphorus is given. How much? 9.3. What is its atomic weight? 31. We are not multiplying it by any number because it is only one phosphorus in the balanced equation. Therefore, 1 into 31 is 31 is equal to how much volume of nitrogen dioxide divided by 5 into 22.4. Here, 5 moles of nitrogen dioxide is formed. 1 mole occupies 22.4. Therefore, if you find out X value, X is equal to, bring this value here, 9.3 into 5 into 22.4 divided by 31. If you do the simplification, you will get the answer. Okay, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Doing the calculation, it is simply mathematics, isn't it? Just, if you just understand, that is more than enough. So watch it again and again until you understand it very thoroughly. You try to work out yourself. You can be sure of 5 marks based on these kind of problems. So thank you very much, children. Until we meet next time. Bye bye.